Now, NBC5 First Warning Weather, the area's certified most accurate forecast.
Well, it may not have hit 90 today, mm-hmm. but when I got in the car this afternoon to come to work,
probably said 99.
No, right? It said 100. Close. It said 100.
Well, this is a cool example of why you don't use the car thermometer to look for an official number.
Oh, that's why we have you.
Absolutely not. It was sitting down the driveway for 4 hours.
Yeah. The highest I've seen so far is 88, or 89, I should say. But it still could get to 90, especially with the warmer air still surging in. It's not out of the question to actually have a high temperature between 5 and 6 p.m. these days. And speaking of water temperature, look at the progress here. Last couple of days, very close to 60 degrees. But again, that is about 8 feet below the top of the water. So if you're just going in near the edge, it's more like 65, probably, Letty, something like that. This is Plattsburgh. We're still tracking some of that low-level smoke. It's not very thick, but there's certainly a haziness to the sky. If you look carefully, that's the silhouette of Mount Mansfield in the distance. Plattsburgh at the airport sitting at 84 right now, but a beautiful dew point of 51. So not humid, but very warm. St. Albans is 87. Even Tupper Lake and Newcomb way up in the 80s today. But all of us will probably be at least 5 degrees hotter tomorrow. So mid-90s are in the cards for a lot of lower elevation spots as we get into the afternoon tomorrow. Got a totally clear scan on Storm Tracker. That includes clouds and rain. No rain really to see until you get out to northern Michigan there. But as we get into Friday, we'll have a front that triggers some thunderstorms for a change. It has been so quiet on that front. It'll change on Friday. So here's the sunshine tomorrow morning. Hazy sun again. There might be one little shower that pops up between the border and Montreal, but that would be the exception tomorrow. Most of us are still dry, some puffy clouds in the sky. You can kind of tell that it's a record-breaking day. And then on Friday, we start out dry. In fact, the morning is fine on Friday. By 1 o'clock, though, we start seeing some showers fire. They likely form over the mountains first. You can see this is like over Scroon Lake and Point South. Also Killington Point South, Friday 1 p.m., but the map really lights up through the day. Now, the severe potential is limited. It would likely be isolated damaging wind gusts on Friday. There's not a lot of wind energy for an organized line of storms, but a lot of us will get wet in the afternoon and evening on Friday, and it's a push of colder air coming down from the north. A lot of times, cold fronts come in from the west. That's not how it works this Friday. It's going to come in kind of like from the northeast. Now, the problem here going into the weekend is that it gets hung up just to our south. So a lot of us are dry on Saturday, but we're watching this potential of lingering showers, at least for southern spots on Saturday. A couple days out, though, that might shift a little bit. We just need that front to keep going when it passes through on Friday. So on Lake Champlain tomorrow, 5 to 10 knots, not too much wave action, temperature of the water 59, as we discussed earlier. So here's the 5-day forecast, 94. That's what we're forecasting for the Champlain Valley tomorrow, and that's easily a new record, smashes the old one by 4 degrees. And then we've got the thunder in there Friday afternoon and evening, those showers nearby or south on Saturday. And it's a cool weekend, upper 60s, close to 70, but we don't have any big time heat once we get out of this stretch. All of next week, upper 60s and lower 70s.